In this tutorial for setting up a Facebook business page, I'll take you through step by step on exactly how to do it, as well as focusing on a few key areas where people tend to get stuck. All right, let's get into it. What's up, busy people? Welcome to 5-Minute Social Media, where we help businesses grow their revenue with social media and simplify it so it doesn't take up so much of your time. That sounds like something you could use. Take a second, hit subscribe, click that bell. That way you'll be notified each week when we release another helpful video. My name is Jerry Potter. Yes, it rhymes with the boy wizard. And I'm gonna show you how to set up your Facebook business page using best practices, the right way, so you only have to do it once. 3 easy things you're gonna need before you set up your Facebook business page, and you probably already have these. 1 is a photo that's gonna be your profile photo. Could be your face, if you're the face of the company, or it could be your logo. 2 is another photo or any other photos that you think would be good on your Facebook business page, anything from your business. And if you don't have one, that's fine. And the last thing is any pertinent info about your business. I assume you know your business's website, if you have one, phone number, email, that sort of thing, all right? Once you've got all that, let's set up your Facebook business page.
There's a couple of places you can start from. 1, if you're just logged into your Facebook page, and you do, by the way, have to have a Facebook personal profile before you can create a Facebook business page. Even if you have no friends, it's your login for the Facebook business page. But you sit here on Facebook, and then you go up here to create, and then just click page to create a page. Or if you're in Facebook Business Manager, click on Business Settings. Then here under Pages, Add, and then Create New Page. On this screen, you're gonna choose, are you a business or a brand, or are you a community or public figure? So choose whichever one makes the most sense for you. Click Get Started. Then you're gonna wanna name your page. You can name your page whatever you want, even if somebody else has the same name. Now, that's not necessarily the best idea if you're trying to have your business or brand stand out. But just go ahead and type in whatever your name is going to be. I've had this thing with animals lately for some reason. So we're gonna do that. And then you wanna put a category to describe your page. When you start typing, different categories will come up. If for some reason you don't see what you want, for example, I was gonna call this an energy drink. Well, there is not an energy drink option. So then I can try beverage. There you go, food and beverage. So now that's gonna be my primary category. If you're really having trouble finding something, type in the word company. A bunch of different types of companies will come up. You even see nonprofit in there. A generic one you could use for now if you don't see anything is just brand. Business is a good one that brings up a bunch of generic ones. And if you're just a business owner, it could even be entrepreneur. You can change this later if you need to. Next, you're gonna wanna add a profile photo. If you are the face of the company, I strongly recommend your face because people connect with faces. But if you're not the face of the company, then your company logo is great. If you're gonna create your profile picture in another editing program, I recommend 400 pixels by 400 pixels is just a nice square size that looks good on all devices and also translates well if you're setting up an Instagram and a Twitter and a LinkedIn and other things. But either way, if you just have an image you're using, go ahead and just use it as is. Facebook will let you crop it. Just make sure that it's at least 180 pixels by 180 pixels. Anything smaller, it's gonna look pixelated and just not look good on some devices. Next, you're gonna wanna add a cover photo. This is the photo that goes across the top of your business page. So this could be anything that represents your business, and you can get really strategic with this. But if you're just setting it up, just choose something to go up there. And that's it, you have a Facebook business page. But there are a few more steps you should do to kind of make sure it's fully set up and optimized. You'll see this box pop up where it'll say, hey, invite your friends. You actually have some likes on your page. They want you to try and get to 10 likes just to kind of get going there. I would suggest coming up here, I'm gonna go to change cover, choose from photos, I'm gonna tap the cover photos there, then I'm gonna select that and it's gonna let me reposition it. So if your photo didn't come out quite the way you want, you can move it around like that. Over here, if you didn't like the way this came out, you can hit update, upload photo. And this time it'll give you the choice to move it, zoom in, out, get it looking exactly the way that you want. Last thing you wanna do is click on this about tab and fill out as much information as you can, because this is how people are going to find you. And when they do find you, you wanna make sure that they know how to contact you, if they wanna hire you, work with you, anything like that. So go through, make sure you've got your phone number, your email if relevant, your website. You can add other accounts in here. You can actually link to Instagram. It'll be an actual link. You can put in your link for Twitter and Snapchat and some of these other ones. Because Facebook is not plain nice, they won't have it be an actual clickable link, but you might as well list them so that they're there. If you wanted to change anything from before, like your category or your page name, you can do all of that in here. Clicking Edit Page Info up here on the right will actually let you go through and do everything all at once. And if you do nothing else, take the time to create a page username. That's by clicking on this here. I just type in at Koala Bear. It's going to tell me, nope, that's not available. So you got to put something in that is not used by another page. That is available. Create username. Now in your browser, your Facebook business page's address is facebook.com/thecaffeinatedkoala or whatever username you chose. So that way it's easy to refer people to it from other pages.
All right, once you've got your Facebook business page all set up, feel free to share a link in the comments. And as you are growing your business, there are certain things you can do to make your social media so much simpler and faster. In fact, a lot of businesses have cut their workload with social media in half. You want to grab this free guide on the screen right now? Cut your social media workload in half. Thank you so much for watching. If this video was helpful, take a second to hit subscribe, give this video a like, or leave me a comment. I read every single one.